ओम अंबिगे मगने विनायका
अम्बे मा ॐ जय शिव शंकर जय अभयंकर
जय शिव शंकर
शिव शंकर जय अभयंकर
जय शिव शंकर जय अभयंकर
सांब सदा शिव शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव हर रे
सांब सदा शिव शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव हर रे
जय शिव शंकर जय अभयंकर
जय शिव शंकर जय अभयंकर
जय गंगाधर जय बिंबाधर
जय गंगाधर जय बिंबाधर
जय गंगाधर जय बिंब गाधर
जय गंगाधर जय बिंबाधर
बाघंबरधर शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव हर रे बाघंबरधर शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव हर रे अभयंकर
जय शिव शंकर जय अभयंकर
जय शिव शंकर जय अभयंकर सांब सदा शिव शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव हर रे सदा शिव शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव हर रे
सांब सदा शिव शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव हर रे
जय शिव शंकर जय अभयंकर शिव शंकर जय अभयंकर
जय शिव शंकर जय अभयंकर
जय गंगाधर जय बिंबाधर
जय गंगाधर जय बिंबाधर
जय
गंगाधर जय बिंबाधर
बाघम धर शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव हर रे
बागंबर धर शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव
बागंबर धर शिव हर रे शिव हर रे शिव हर रे जय शिव शंकर जय अभयंकर
ओम श्री राम कृष्ण भगवान की जय।
ओम हरिनारायण गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
हरिनारायण गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
हरिनारायण गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा हरिनारायण गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
हरिनारायण गोविंदा
हरिनारायण गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
हरिनारायण गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
आपत पांडव गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
आपत पांडव गोविंदा
पांडव गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
आपत पांडव गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
हरिनारायण गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
हरिनारायण
अनाथराक्षक गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
अनाथराक्षक गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
अनाथराक्षक गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
अनाथराक्षक
हरिनारायण गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
हरिनारायण गोविंदा जगनारायण गोविंदा
वेणु विलोला गोविंदा विजय गोपाल गोविंदा
वेणु विलोला गोविंदा विजय गोपाल गोविंदा
वेणु विलोला गोविंदा विजय गोपाल गोविंदा
वेणु विलोला गोविंदा विजय
गोविंद जगन्नारायण गोविंद
हरि नारायण गोविंद जगन्नारायण गोविंद
राम कृष्ण तत्सत राम कृष्ण ओम ओम जगन्नारायण गोविंद
राम कृष्ण तत्सत् राम कृष्ण ओम ओम जगन्नारायण
राम कृष्ण तत्सत् राम कृष्ण ओम ओम जगन्नारायण गोविंद
राम कृष्ण तत्सत् राम कृष्ण ओम ओम जगन्नारायण गोविंद
हरि नारायण गोविंद जगन्नारायण गोविंद
हरि नारायण गोविंद
अभक्त पांडव गोविंदा जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
अभक्त पांडव गोविंदा जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
अनाथ रक्षक गोविंदा जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
अनाथ रक्षक गोविंदा जगन्नारायण
नारायण गोविंदा जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
हरि नारायण गोविंदा जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
वेणु विलोला गोविंदा विजय गोपाल गोविंदा
वेणु विलोला गोविंदा विजय गोपाल गोविंदा
राम कृष्ण तत्सत् राम कृष्ण ओम ओम जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
राम कृष्ण तत्सत् राम कृष्ण ओम ओम जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
राम कृष्ण तत्सत् राम कृष्ण ओम ओम जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
राम कृष्ण तत्सत् राम कृष्ण ओम ओम जगन्नारायण
नारायण गोविंदा जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
हरि नारायण गोविंदा जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
हरि नारायण गोविंदा जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
हरि नारायण गोविंदा जगन्नारायण
नारायण गोविंदा जगन्नारायण गोविंदा
ओम श्री राम कृष्ण भगवान की जय ओम ऐं सर्वदेव देवी स्वरूपाय श्री राम कृष्णाय नमः ओम नमो नारायणाय डियर सिस्टर्स ब्रदर्स एंड लविंग चिल्ड्रन लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद द रीडिंग फ्रॉम द गॉस्पल ऑफ श्री राम कृष्ण डेट इज मंडे 18th June 1883 द चैप्टर फेस्टिवल एट पानीहाती वी हैड रेड अबाउट हाउ Sri Ramakrishna was in an ecstatic mood. He had joined the crowd as they sang devotional songs and danced. Thereafter, they had prasad. Now, Navadvip introduced his son to the master. The young man, who was a student of the scriptures, saluted the master. Sri Ramakrishna advised him, "Too much study of the scriptures does more harm than good. The important thing is to know the essence of the scriptures. One should learn the essence and then dive deep in order to realize God." The master used to give the illustration of a shopping list. He used to say, once you purchase the items, you do not require the list anymore. Similarly, once we know the essence of the scriptures, we must put the teachings into practice. Then we will reap the benefit of it. It is good to quote from the scriptures, but it is also important to practice the teachings in order to progress. So therefore, the master guides this young man that he must also put the teachings into practice. The master says, the Divine Mother has revealed to me the essence of the Vedanta. It is that Brahman alone is real and the world is illusory. The essence of the Gita is what you get by repeating the word 10 times, Gita, 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 Gi. The word becomes reversed. It is then Tyagi, which refers to renunciation. The essence of the Gita is, O man, renounce everything and practice spiritual discipline for the realization of God. Navadvip says, how can we persuade our minds to renounce the world? The master encouraged him, saying, you are a Goswami. It is your duty to officiate as a priest in the temple. You cannot renounce the world, otherwise, who would look after the temple and its services? You have to renounce mentally. So Sri Ramakrishna also used to encourage all householders to renounce mentally. There are many duties to attend to, and people cannot forsake everything. They have to renounce mentally and do what has to be done. Sri Ramakrishna continues, it is God Himself who has kept you in the world to set an example to others. You may resolve in your mind 1,000 times to renounce the world, but you will not succeed. God has given you such a nature that you must perform your worldly duties. Sri Krishna said to Arjuna, what do you mean you will not fight? By your mere will, you cannot refrain from fighting. Your very nature will make you fight. Our revered Guruji used to say that, at home, everything is found and you live comfortably. So do your duties well and then think of God. So if you renounce the world, then you have to go around to beg for your food. But at home, everything is found. So it's easier to think of God when everything is available. At the mere mention of Krishna and Arjuna, the master went into samadhi. In the twinkling of an eye, his body became motionless. His eyes were transfixed and his breathing could scarcely be noticed. At this sudden transformation, Navadvip, his son, and the other devotees looked at the master in mute wonder. Regaining partial consciousness, he said to Navadvip, yoga and bhoga, you have both spirituality and material pleasures. Now, your only duty is to call on God and pray to Him sincerely. O God, I do not want the glories of your world-bewitching Maya. I want you alone. God dwells in all beings undoubtedly. That being the case, who may be called His devotee? He who dwells in God. He who has merged his mind, his life, and innermost soul in God. Beautiful words these are for us to learn. The master used to always warn his disciples about God's world-bewitching Maya. Maya indicates that the world is not real, in the sense that it is not eternal. While living in the world, we have to be careful to whom or to what we give our hearts. We tend to become attached to the fleeting things of the world and when they perish, we suffer. Master always teaches us to do our duties, but give our hearts to God. In other words, every morning and evening, we must remember to say our prayers and meditate. Gradually, we will become attached to God. Word bewitching means being enchanted or fascinated by. This in turn implies that we can easily forget God and become mesmerized by His glories. The Upanishads say that the senses have been made in such a way that they always go outward. Wise is the one who turns his or mind and senses within. Through meditation, we train or discipline the mind to look at the Atman within. The master becomes absorbed in God at the mere mention of God's name. Now the master returned to the normal plane of consciousness. Referring to his samadhi, the absorption in God thought, he said to Navadvip, "Some say that this state of mine is a disease. I say to them, how can one become unconscious by thinking of him whose consciousness has made the whole world conscious?" So what Master means is that he is thinking about God who is consciousness itself. So he cannot be unconscious, or he cannot be unaware of what is happening. He is unconscious of the world, but is in a superconscious state in which he feels the bliss of communion with God. Knowledge about God is the ultimate reality, the ultimate knowledge. By knowing God, Master has the highest and best knowledge, which gives one complete satisfaction and infinite peace. After attaining God, one requires nothing else. If there is anything to know after knowing God, then God Himself gives us that knowledge. God Himself makes us aware of what we should know. The Master and the devotees took a carriage to return to Dakshineshwar. They were going to pass the temple garden of Mati Seal on the way. For a long time, the master had been asking M to take him to the reservoir in the garden so that he might teach M how to meditate on the formless aspect of God. There were tame fish in the reservoir. Nobody harmed them. Visitors threw puffed rice and other bits of food into the water, and the big fish came in swarms to eat the food. Fearlessly, the fish swam in the water and sported joyously. When they arrived at the reservoir, the master said to M, "Look at the fish. Meditating on the formless God is like swimming joyfully like these fish in the ocean of bliss and consciousness." These are very, very stimulating descriptions, very encouraging, and we ourselves feel that we must sit quietly and meditate. It is very helpful to sit quietly for a few minutes every day to practice meditation. Gradually, as we enjoy this peace and quietness, we can increase the time of meditation. This not only helps the restless mind to become calm, but also gives us inner strength to face our challenges. By praying to God, He guides us and shows us the way forward. Especially when the mind is disturbed, we must sit quietly and look at any picture of God that we love and feel the presence of God in that picture. And when we talk to God, God will certainly answer our query, give us answers that we need to help us in any situation. Om Shanti, शांति शांति ही।
ओम हो जगना पालनहार, हो जगना पालनहार, मने तारो एक सहारो छे। आवे
ओ सत्संग लेली बहावे
Sisters, brothers, and loving children, let us sit calmly and concentrate our minds on God. Prayer helps to control the restless mind and gives us inner peace. Sri Ramakrishna says, the easiest way to concentrate the mind during meditation is to look intently at the flame of a lamp or a candle. Through regular practice, the mind becomes controlled and rests in God. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Om, Om Sarvesha Swastir Bhavatu. Sarvesham Shantir Bhavatu, Sarvesham Purnam Bhavatu, Sarvesham Mangalam Bhavatu, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, दुःखभाग् भवेत् ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति Shanti, Shanti, Hari Om Tat Sat.
Jai Shri Guru Maharaj Ki
Jai,
Mahamai Ki
Jai,
Swami Ji Maharaj Ki
Jai,
Ganga Mat Ki
Jai,
Mahavir Swami Ji Ki
Jai,
Sarva Rishi Munin Ki
Jai, Parvati Patay Hara Hara, Mahavir